الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد All praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we send our salutations to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear brothers and sisters, welcome to the Jummah prayer at Britain's first mosque. Those of you who are watching us online, you will not be able to pray behind the imam, but you can listen to the khutbah, inshallah. COVID has not left the country, the world yet. We are still under threat. Liverpool is under tier two, which means we can do certain things and we can't do everything. So I would ask every congregation members to take precautions by wearing face masks, bringing in prayer mats, carrier bag for the shoes, and if you are going outdoor, please make sure you are protected in public spaces. Many people are still losing life. Over 500 people are dying every day because of COVID contraction. So please, please be very careful. If you are elderly and have any symptoms, please do not come to the masjid. And children under the age of 12 are not permitted at all. Now, to say that the masjid is open all the time for all prayers, the old mosque is open 5 times a prayer, so please do come in, but make sure you take extra care when you are coming into the building. Just to say that please make dua for the deceased of one of our greatest supporters and a regular member of this congregation, Dr. Al-Said. She lost her mom a couple of years ago, and then her brother-in-law, her father, and of course her late husband, who passed away 8th of January a couple of years ago. So please make dua for all the deceased. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give her the strength to cope and move on in life. Make sure we all pray for all our loved ones, those who are not in this world, and those who have no children. Make dua for those deceased, that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive their sins and accept him in his arm. So please do so. Those who've been attracted with coronavirus or any form of illness, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them the shifa. The other announcement is that we still are looking for people who want to learn English, improve their employability skills and business skills. The course will be run early January now. And please make sure if you're interested, please register yourselves with us by calling us on the number from our website. So inshallah, please make sure, Brother Muhammad, where are you to do the collections? So Brother Muhammad, please make sure you pay generously to the masjid. And of course, anything that you can give towards the purchase of the mosque. We are actually very close to buying the building and we are a bit short of funds. So please make effort to give Sadaqatul Jariyah to the house of Allah. As you know, when you help build a masjid in this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps you build a palace in Jannah. Jazakumullah khairan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you safe and well. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum. One last thing. After the Jummah prayer, just after 2 o'clock, we'll be live on air with the Imam Show with Sheikh Haroon and Sheikh Wadda Saleh. Please join us on AQS Media. Go to our Facebook, like it, share it, and AQS Media, subscribe it, and press the bell button. That will remind you of every time we come on the air. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا هدانا الله. الحمد لله المنعم المتفضل الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، شهادة نرجو بها النجاة يوم اللقاء. وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا وقرة عيوننا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، خير نبي أرسله، أرسله الله بالحق بشيرًا ونذيرًا وداعياً إلى الله بإذنه وسراجاً منيراً. فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه كلما ذكره الذاكرون وكلما غفل عن ذكره الغافلون. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. فأوصيكم أيها المؤمنون بتقوى الله. اتقوا الله يا عباد الله، اتقوا الله في السر والعلن. O believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has instructed us at all times, but particularly on the Jumu'ah, by saying, O those who have believed, be fearful and conscious of Allah as He truly deserves, and only die as Muslims. O those who have believed, be fearful of and conscious of Allah, and let every soul look at what it's unfold for tomorrow. Tomorrow, Yawm al-Qiyamah, the Day of Judgment. And be fearful and conscious of Allah because He knows everything that you do. So believers on this blessed day of Jumu'ah and all days, اتقوا الله يا عباد الله. Be fearful and conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at every single moment. And be conscious and aware that you have a Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. ما يكون من نجوى ثلاثة إلا هو رابعهم ولا خمسة إلا هو سادسهم ولا أدنى من ذلك ولا أكثر إلا هو معهم أينما كان. Always remember, you're never alone. There's two of you in secret, talking and conversing in secret, he's the third. If there's five of you, he's the sixth. If there's more or less, he's with you wherever you are. You cannot hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So be fearful and conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything you do. Especially Yawm al-Jumu'ah, Khayr al-Ayyam. The best of all days in the week is the Jumu'ah. Sayyid al-Ayyam, the greatest of all days. Where, when we wake up, after we prayed our salah in the morning, we begin to prepare ourselves for this great moment of Khutbatul Jumu'ah. This great moment of Khutbatul Jumu'ah. The whole week revolves around this moment. And we take our ghusl, as the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has advised us to do. And we wear the best of all clothes, and tatayyub, and we put on our perfume. And we try and make sure that we come at the time when the angels write down our names. Because when the khatib starts, they fold the scrolls and no more names are written down. So we try to come before the scrolls are folded and so that our names are recorded. So that at the very least we get an egg. Those who come just before the khutbah begins, the Prophet ﷺ told us it's like they've given the reward or like they've given an egg in charity and they get that reward. The earlier and earlier they come, it increases to the point it's like sacrificing a camel and giving that in reward. And so then when we come to the Jumu'ah, we pray our raka'at before. We make dua to Allah Ta'ala in the hope that it's sa'at al-ijaba, in the hope that it's the time when du'as are accepted. And the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us between every two adhans there's a dua that's not rejected. And the dua, the two adhans of Jumu'ah are more than any normal adhan. So we make a point as we're waiting for the khutbah to start to raise our hands to Him Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala and then to make a dua. And then when the khatib comes, complete silence. Complete silence. Back in the days when we sat next to each other, unfortunately, like some of us still thought that we're just sitting at home and having a conversation with each other. Even though Allah spoke about khutbah till Jumu'ah and He told us, فَسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Khutbah till Jumu'ah is the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whilst the khutbah is going on, nothing should be said. Because a person who speaks during the khutbah, فَلَا جُمُعَةَ لَهِ. He has no Jumu'ah. He's lost all the thawab and all the ajr and all the hasanat of his Jumu'ah. And so now that we're forced to have gaps between us, some of us are still on our phones. Some of us are still on our phones like we can't let go of the dunya even for 5-10 minutes. Like we can't break from the world even for 5-10 minutes. We're so addicted. We're so addicted to it that we can't let go and just connect subhanahu wa ta'ala just for some moments. Unique moments. Like don't mess around with your phones while the khutbah's going on. It used to be, don't talk to each other. Now we can't, because then you'll be shouting at each other. But now, switch your phones off. You shouldn't even be talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no dhikr, there's Quran, there's nothing except for istima' al-khutbah. Except for listening to the khutbah, because these are the unique moments where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wipe away sins of a whole week just by maintaining adab al-jum'ah. And then when we leave, we have a brief moment, 15-20 minutes, listen to the khutbah. Then after that we pray our salah. فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Like don't do dhikr during the khutbah. Don't be reading Quran during the khutbah. Don't make dua during the khutbah. If you can't even do those things, don't even do a nahi an al-munkar. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us, مَنْ قَالَ لِصَاحِبِهِ أَنْصِتْ وَالْإِمَامُ يَخْطُبْ فَقَدْ لَغَى وَمَنْ لَغَى فَلَا جُمْعَةَ لَهُ. Don't even tell that person not to speak. Don't even tell the person next to you not to speak. And النهي عن المنكر, which is one of the great pillars of this religion, forbidding wrong and telling people not to do wrong. None of that can happen. So definitely no normal conversation. Definitely we shouldn't be checking our WhatsApp. Focus on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Pray your salah. Pray your asr after we finish. Then go back to work. Go back home. Go back to work. And then do dhikr Allah. Not during khutbah. Then do dhikr Allah. وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. In these strange moments that we live in the world, in these strange days that we live in the world, the strangeness and the uniqueness of it is becoming almost like normal to us. Like we're normalized now to accept our prayer like this, which is a weird, strange prayer. It's become normal for us. Normal that we have to stay indoors all day long. But what we're seeing are things unfolding in front of our very eyes. There are things that are unfolding in front of our very eyes, a lot of which, and most of which, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. We're going to mention and speak about certain signs of Yawm al-Qiyamah, of the Day of Judgment. And when we hear alamat al-sa'ah, the signs of the Day of Judgment, what we should say and think to ourselves, Sadaqa Rasulullah. Sadaqa Rasulullah. Have no doubt. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's a sadiq al-masduq. He's truthful in everything that he said. And he's believed in everything that he said. He would stand on the minbar from Fajr until Maghrib on occasions and speak about everything that's going to happen until Yawm al-Qiyamah. And they're describing it. It's being described to them as though they're watching it directly. What's going on right now? All this weird, strange things that are going on in the world right now, which are becoming normal. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw it. He was shown it. And he told us everything that was going to happen. When Jibreel alayhi salam comes to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hadith Jibreel, أخبرني عن الإسلام. He tells him what is Islam. أخبرني عن الإيمان. He tells him what is iman, what's faith. أخبرني عن الإحسان. He tells إحسان, what's excellence in worship. The three cornerstones of our religion. Iman, what we believe. Islam, our practice. إحسان, the best way to practice. أن تعبد الله كأنك ترى. Worship Allah as though you see Him. But Jibreel alayhi salam doesn't stop there. He doesn't stop. Now we have ثلاثة أركان. Three essential pillars of our religion. But there's a fourth. We talk about aqidah. We talk about salah and zakah and siyam. Prayer, fasting, zakah. We talk about how to better ourselves in our duty to Allah and other believers. But what's the fourth? أخبرني عن الساعة. متى الساعة? Tell me, when will the trumpet be blown? Tell me, when's the day of judgment? Tell me when it's all coming to an end. الركن الرابع من أركان الدين. The fourth of the essential cornerstone pillars of our religion that every believer should know about, such that when we're witnessing all the madness that's going on in the world, صدق رسول الله. He told us. We're not surprised. It's crazy. But we're not surprised, because there's even crazier things that are going to come. If we hold on to a Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, nothing will surprise you, because he told us. أخبرني عن الساعة ما المسؤول عنها بأعلم من السائل. The one who's been asked knows no better than one who's asking. فأخبرني عن أماراتها. Tell me about its signs. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then tells him, إذا رأيت المرأة تلد ربتها فذاك من أشراطها وإذا رأيت الحفاة العراة الصم البكمة ملوك الأرض فذاك من أشراطها وإذا رأيت رعاء البهم يتطاولون في البنيان فذاك من أشراطها. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم told us, when you see a woman giving birth to her master, her mistress, the one who owns and controls her, that's from the signs. What does that mean? There was an old explanation that the ulama gave. Well, many of the imams, they explain this as saying, like the disobedience, the rebellion that we see from sons and daughters towards their parents, where the daughters and sons treat their mothers like their own slaves. Treat their mothers like their own slaves. When children, they abuse their parents, they disrespect their parents, they dishonor their parents, it's become as though she's your slave. Your mother's your slave. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam foretold her. We don't negate the literal. We don't say, no, it doesn't mean. There was another meaning that applied. But right now we're seeing. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us that there'll come a time where he said, وَالْوَلَدُ غَيْظًا وَالْمَطَرُ قَيْظًا وَالْوَلَدُ غَيْظًا. And you'll see acidic rain, burning rain. And you'll see children full of anger. Children full of anger. Children who disrespect their parents, their father and the mother. فَذَاكَ مِنْ أَشْرَاطِهَا. Never happened before, not to this level. It never happened. The generation that we're seeing now, the disrespect that's leveled against mothers, has never happened before to this degree. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam foretold her. But he also foretold, when you see al-hufat, al-urah, al-sum al-bukma, muluk al-ard, and that's where they are now. When you see people who are in the desert, naked, barefoot, they could barely speak, they now become the kings of the world. And there they are now. You see the states all around the peninsula, you see states all around the Arabian Peninsula, who not so long ago, one or two generations back, they're exactly as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. Come straight out of the desert, and now the muluk al-ard. Now they are the kings of the earth. Now they own unimaginable wealth. What do we say? Sadaqa Rasulullah. He spoke the absolute truth. When yesterday, one of these states is now normalizing relations with the taghiyat al-ard, the terrorist state in this earth, when they're normalizing the normal relations with Israel, with the terrorist state, فَذَاكَ مِنْ أَشْرَاطِهَا. There we have signs playing out in front of us. These have now become muluk al-ard. They're now kings of the world. They don't care about al-mustada'afina fil-ard. No more care and concern about the weak and the oppressed and the persecuted, Palestinians and every other land. فَذَاكَ مِنْ أَشْرَاطِهَا. That's what the Prophet ﷺ told us. When you see what happened yesterday, you get all angry, you get all upset. فَذَاكَ مِنْ أَشْرَاطِهَا. Prophet said, that's from the signs of Yawm al-Qiyam. And he also told us, when you see Ru'a al-Buham, shepherds, they only used to have camels and sheep and goats. Now what are they doing? يَتَطَاوَلُونَ فِي الْبُنْيَانِ. Are you seeing? You're seeing hotels, Burj this and Burj that and Burj, like going as high as possible, building the highest possible building. Sadaqa Rasulullah. Sadaqa Rasulullah. He saw this taking place. He told us and he said, فَذَاكَ مِنْ أَشْرَاطِهَا. That's from the signs of the Day of Judgment. What we're seeing unraveling in front of us, these are all from the signs of the Day of Judgment. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam began with himself. He said, بُعِثْتُ أَنَا وَالسَّاعَةُ هَكَذَا. بُعِثْتُ أَنَا وَالسَّاعَةُ هَكَذَا. I was sent on the Day of Judgment and me are like this. I am the sign. When the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was sent for us, he's the beginning of the end. He's Nabi Akhir al-Zaman. And he told us about everything that's going to happen. مِنْ عَلَامَاتِ السَّاعَةِ. So much that he told us. We're doing it. And we're to blame. تَقْلِيدَ الْيَهُودُ وَالنَّصَارَ. مِنْ عَلَامَاتِ السَّاعَةِ تَقْلِيدَ الْيَهُودُ وَالنَّصَارَ. We mentioned this last week. I'm going to keep on mentioning it. 2 weeks away, it's Christmas. It's Christmas. Forget about here. Even in the Muslim world, we're going to have Christmas trees. We're going to have Christmas turkeys. We're going to have Christmas this. Christmas parties. Dressing up for Christmas. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, لا تقوم الساعة حتى تأخذ أمتي بأخذ القرون قبلها شبرا بشبر وذراعا بذراع. He said, the Day of Judgment will not come to pass until my ummati, until my nation, they will take and follow the ways of those who came before. شبرا بشبر, handspan by handspan, arm span, arm length by arm length, following them and copying them in everything. فَقِيلَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ كَفَارِسْ وَالرُّومِ قَالَ وَمَنِ النَّاسِ إِلَّا أُولَئِكَ. قِيلَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. They said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, is that the Persians and the Romans? He said, who are the people except for them? Who are the people except for them? وَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ سُنَنَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ شِبْرًا بِشِبْرٍ وَذِرَاعًا بِذِرَاعٍ حتى لو دخل جحر ضب تبعتموه. You'll follow them. You'll follow them. Those nations that came before, the Christians in particular, Ar-Rum, the Christians in particular, you're going to follow them. You're going to copy them. Handspan by handspan, arm length by arm length, everything they're going to do, you're going to do. To the point, you no longer have your identity of Muslim. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this seems so simple. You study about him. He used to have his hair in a particular style. He used to keep his hair in a particular style. When he comes to Medina, he changes his hairstyle just to be like the Jews and to be different to the Mushrikeen. Once the Muslims have dominated and controlled, he now changes it so he doesn't look like the Jews anymore. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, down to his hair, how he kept his hair. Is there a sunnah that you must follow in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in how you keep your hair? No, there isn't. He never told us. He told us keep your beard. He told us grow your beard. But he didn't tell us you must keep your hair in a certain way. But he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made a point. When he came into Medina, he kept different from the mushrikeen of Mecca, like the Jews. But once there's no longer mushrikeen to worry about, and there's only Jews, now the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, khaliful mushrikeen, khaliful yahood, khaliful sara. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam down to everything. The identity of the Prophet ﷺ, we are not them. We are not them. We are believers. This is in her. Now we're doing what they do in their religion. Now we're doing what they're doing in their religion. The Prophet ﷺ said, if they entered into a lizard hole, جِحْرَ ضَبٍ لَتَّبَعْتُمُوهُمْ. You'd go down there with them. And right now, that lizard hole is packed out with Muslims. Every single Muslim trying to get into every single lizard hole. When we come to Christmas, make a point of reminding yourself and your children and your family and any Muslim, we are Muslim. We have our a'yad. We have our festivities. We have our ways. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us, this is min ashrat al-sa'ah. This is from the signs of the Day of Judgment. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us so much about these signs. It's all there in front of our very eyes. Believe in him, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And when you see anything, he told us about khumur. He told us about alcohol drinking being rampant. He told us about akla riba. He told us that people will be dealing with interest in everything they do to the point where a Muslim doesn't even care about halal money anymore. We're there. We're there. Because we turned on our backs on a Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تُطِيعُوا فَرِيقًا مِّنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابِ يَرُدُّوكُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ كَافِرِينَ وَكَيْفَ تَكْفُرُونَ وَأَنْتُمْ تُتْلَى عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتُ اللَّهِ وَفِيكُمْ رَسُولُهُ وَكَيْفَ تَكْفُرُونَ وَأَنْتُمْ تُتْلَى عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتُ اللَّهِ وَفِيكُمْ رَسُولُهُ وَمَنْ يَعْتَصِمْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ هُدِيَ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. In the time of النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, Aws and Khazraj, and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam brought their hearts together. He's united them. He's unified them. One man, old man, hated Muslims so much. He sees them sitting down, Aws and Khazraj, in peace, loving each other, caring for each other, hearts united, hearts brought together. It angers him. It angers him. He hates the fact that the Muslims, their hearts are together. He hates that. So he sends one of the young Jewish men to recite poetry of Ansar and Khazraj about the wars. Read the poetry. Because Aws, just 5 years before Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, were victorious in Harb Wa'ath. Read the poetry. Sits in the middle of them, he starts reading poetry praising Aws. Khazrajiyin are getting angry. Angry. Weapons come on. The weapons come on. They agree to have a duel and fight. The Ansar are now about to go into war with each other. The days before Islam. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam comes and reminds them, like, what's this jahiliyyah? What's this ways of jahiliyyah? When I came and I removed all of that from you, I made you into one. Allah SWT revealed this ayah. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, in tuti'u fariqan min alladhina utul kitab. Oh, believe it, if you obey them and follow them and go down that lizard hole with them, the Jews, they'll turn you back into kafir. You become unbelievers. How can you be unbelievers? كيف تكفرون? Why do you feel that you need to be like them when you have the Qur'an? تتلى عليكم آيات الله. Every morning in your homes, read the Qur'an. Reflect over the Qur'an. You have the ultimate guidance. وفيكم رسوله. And you have Nabi Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Qur'an and the Sunnah never left us. But we left the Qur'an and Sunnah. The Qur'an and Sunnah never left us. The word of Allah is always there. The way Muhammad is always there. وَمَنْ يَعْتَصِمْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ هُدِيَ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Hold firm. Hold firm. And then you'll be on the path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As-sa'ah is real. The Day of Judgment is real. But hold firm to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hold firm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون. بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم إنه سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين. الحمد لله الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد. When we hear these narrations about the signs of the Day of Judgment, as we said repeatedly, all we're seeing within this is صدق رسول الله. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came. He told us everything we need to know. He told us everything we need to do. He guided us to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. ما من خير إلا دلنا عليه وما من شر إلا حذرنا منه. There's no good that will ever be except that Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he showed us it. There's no harm that will ever come, any evil, except that he's warned us about it. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ فَالرَّحِيمِ. That's your Nabi. That's your Nabi. He's come to you. He's one of you. He's human like you and I. عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ. All the pain and suffering that through, it's difficult for a Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's hard, it's difficult for him. حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is more concerned for you and I than we are concerned for ourselves. بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفَ الرَّحِيمِ. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Ra'uf, he's Rahim, he's merciful, he's gentle, he's compassionate. So hold on to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Never let go of him. He's going to show us the way through all of this madness that we're going right through right now. Just keep on reading about what he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. He's given us the path of guidance. There's nothing to worry about. There's nothing to be scared of as long as we hold on to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He shows us the way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل وسلم على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين وصل وسلم على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين وصل وسلم على سيدنا محمد حتى ترث الأرض ومن عليها وأنت خير الوارثين. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
لا إله إلا الله. اللهم صل وسلم. استو استقيموا. Make sure the rows are straight. توجهوا بقلوبكم إلى الله. Turn your hearts to Allah. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن تطيعوا فريقا من الذين أوتوا الكتاب يردوكم بعد إيمانكم كافرين. وكيف تكفرون وأنتم تتلى عليكم آيات الله وفيكم رسوله. ومن يعتصم بالله فقد هدي إلى صراط مستقيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سبحان الله أكبر. بسم الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فأصبحتم بنعمته إخوانا وكنتم على شفا حفرة من النار فأنقذكم منها كذلك يبين الله لكم آياته لعلكم تهتدون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله ربنا لك الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر تحية السلام السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله بسم الله الرحمن
الرحيم Assalamu alaikum brothers just to say if you could stay for a second the Salatul Asr In exactly 7 minutes time, it's at 1:37, the azan will go. So if you'd like to join in for the Asr prayer, please stay behind in 7 minutes time, the azan will go for Salatul Asr, inshallah. Those who can't stay, just to remind you that soon after, just after 2 o'clock, we will be on the air with Ask the Sheikh, Ask the Imam program. So please join us, those of you who are watching us online, please join us after 2 o'clock online on AQS Media. Please subscribe the channel, also press the bell button to remind you when we come on the air. Also, every Thursday at 6 p.m. we have this Muslims Got Talent show for children under the age of 16 who can partake in Quranic recitation, hadith, calligraphy, art, and any other things potential that they have, they can showcase that. So that starts every Thursday, 6 p.m. till 7:30 p.m. Inshallah, like I said before, please make dua for the decease of one of our beloved sister who actually contributes a lot as Sadaqatul Jariyah to this masjid, Dr. Al-Said's family, and for her good health. And of course, everyone else who are no longer in this world. The two programs will be running for ESOL class, which is English learning class, employability and business skills. We'll start in January, inshallah, but you need to register. The class is for men and women from the age of 90 till 40 who are not at work. Jazakumullah khairan, inshallah, we will meet again soon.